on campus. Fresh out East Atlanta with no mountains.
The featured artist of Havana, the most popular song of 2018, Jeffrey Lamar Williams, who is otherwise popularly known as Young Thug, is behind the bars since May 2022 on gang-related charges and racketeering. Until the next court trial in January 2023, he is going to be kept captive in hostile conditions. It is not to forget that he was successfully known for shaping the face of contemporary rap and conquering the U.S. mainstream media with his talent and passion for music and rapping. However, right now his life is quite static as he is held for trial in the court with 27 mates of his. This is because his record label, YSL, has been accused of being a criminal street gang. His own lyrics are proving to be the witness against him. It is surely turning into the biggest case of rap trial that the world has witnessed. However, things are not how they used to be. Young Thug has been a very successful rapper in the music world, despite having a traumatizing childhood. Before this accusation and trial began, the world had seen the success of this multi-talented rapper. Early life. The birth name of Young Thug is Jeffrey Lamar Williams, and he was born in Atlanta, Georgia. He was born on 16th August 1991. However, after the birth into his family, he was subjected to tons of traumatizing events in his life. First of all, he was born into a family of 11 children who belonged to different biological fathers. Young Thug was the second youngest son in his family. While he was living with his family in his early life, they were all settled at the demolished Jonesboro South Projects. Ever since he was born, Thug's life was subjected to trial, which was first in the form of his family and then later in the form of his record label, Family Life. Young Thug also had a younger sister, and both these siblings belonged to the same biological father, which helped him have a closer relationship with his sister. The most difficult time in the life of Thug as a child was when he had to face the problem of hunger. His mother was not a well-off woman, and she had to bear the responsibility of taking the responsibility for all the children, which became very difficult work progress for her. It has never been easy to groom children when they are that huge in number and solely by one woman. All these factors, starting from the beginning of his life, somewhat affected him to become a successful rapper and forever change the name of rapping in the music industry. Young Thug did not grow up to be raised in a safe environment at all. All throughout his life, he had been an active part of the circle of crime that regulated in his family. The circle of crime was so popular among his brothers that it had rather become a norm among them. At a very young age, he had to face events that were very traumatizing for his childhood. One such event happened when he had to witness the murder of his elder brother in cold blood. Another event that was generated by his family was the court case, trial, and jail term of his convicted brother. His brother was convicted of murder. These events did not leave a good impact on his life, and soon he was going to be a part of them too. Education and violence. Talking about his educational background, he did attend school for a total of 6 classes in elementary school. However, it was the first time in his life that he actively showed any violence, and the consequence was that he was expelled from school. The reason being him the victim of breaking the arm of his teacher. This incident proved that the dangerous impact of his siblings was taking over him. As a consequence of his action, he was sent to juvenile prison for a term of 4 years. This was the first backdrop in his life, and the life that he spent there was not of worthy living. However, it was also necessary for him because the path that he was choosing to stay on was very dangerous and could have dreadful consequences in the future. When he turned into a teenager, his life went further downhill as he was under the constant influence of his siblings. His elder brothers got him into gambling, and before anyone knew it, he developed more bad habits, including drugs and violence. Young Thug did not cease to participate in activities just for the sake of thrill and fun. Soon he was not even hesitant in taking any risks. It was at this stage of his life that he did the most dangerous things. He wasn't entirely to blame because this is what he had witnessed throughout his entire life, and he developed those habits as a consequence. Turning point. Right at the age of 17, a very surprising event took place in Thug's life, which changed the meaning of his life forever. The first emotionally overwhelming thing that happened to him was when he became a father at this age. It was a shocking incident, but he used it to save himself and make a name in this world. It was the first time ever that he was sentimentally stirred, and he was now ready to bring a change to his habits and lifestyle. But how did he vouch for it? The first thing that he did was having some deep realizations about what he actually wanted in life, and thus he actually realized his passion for music. It was at this moment that he was compelled to start rapping and become the next Lil Wayne of the music industry. it was the first ever life-changing decision that he made, pursuing rap music. What happened next was the first step towards his success. It all started in 2009, when Young Thug knocked at the doors of Dundeel Studio. It was near downtown Atlanta, and he reached there in a purple pea coat over a cropped jersey and paired it with some bell-bottom jeans. His passion drove him intensely when he reached there at the studio. He was only 17 at that time. While he communicated with Dundeel, the only thing that he was uttering consistently was that, "I am going to be the next Lil Wayne." The producer was actually interested to see this passionate young child, and therefore he gave him the chance that changed his life forever and made him step out of the life of poverty. Afterward, the young rapper produced his first debut mixtapes. His mixtape, I Came From Nothing, was an extremely dense attempt of Thug to cultivate an entirely new style of rapping. What he offered through this mixtape was the persona, mystique, and presence. This mixtape caught the attention of music critics, and stardom awaited Young Thug right after this. The next important event in his life was his guest appearance in True Royal's song, She Can Go. It was not long after that the mixtapes of Young Thug caught the attention of a very popular star, Gucci Mane. This was another life-turning event in his life. Gucci Mane was specifically impressed by the song I Came From Nothing, which led him to sign Young Thug for his label. Gucci Mane believed that the work, passion, and personality of Young Thug were very unique, and he was able to identify the spark in him that no one else had seen earlier. It all happened in 2013, when Young Thug released his first album with the record label Gucci Mane. This mixtape was called the 1017 Thug. Young Thug received much appreciation from music critics as well as fans after he released this album. The positive reviews further drove him into creating more passionate music. His hit songs proved very successful, and he was listed on Pitchfork Albums of the Year. Furthermore, he also received an outstanding review from The Complex. Thug was then highly efficient in producing his debut singles that go by the names Stoner and Danny Glover. These two singles brought massive appreciation to the music industry. The song Stoner gained worldwide recognition as it was listed at number 43 on Billboard 100. It was by now that Young Thug actually started to get rewarded for his struggles. However, little did he know that this was just the beginning, and there was so much more to come from him. The best track that was made from this list was the song called Pikachu. It stood out to be the best and was voted as the most favorite one among the listeners. One of Thug's successful endeavors was that he made it through to Rolling Stone with the success of this mixtape. It was a huge success, which was further followed by the approval of this mixtape by The Guardian. The Guardian mentioned it among the top 5 best mixtapes of the year 2013. In order to further strengthen his bonds and fortify his position in the music industry, Young Thug was successful in collaborating with a number of big stars. All his collaborations paid off, and he became highly successful in them. He collaborated on music projects with Travis Scott, Trick Daddy, Alex Toomey, and Danny Brown. Uncountable successes for Young Thug. The most rewarding and blessed year for Young Thug was the year 2014. It was in this year that he recorded a mind-blowing deal of $1.5 million with the label Cash Money Records. His fame and worth had skyrocketed by this time, and he had now become a successful part of the mainstream media. Very successfully, Young Thug recorded a wide variety of incredible songs for the album 1017 Brick Squad. To do so, he had made a collaboration with other high-profile musicians such as Chief Keef, Rich Homie, and Kanye West. It was a tremendous attempt by Young Thug, which was followed by more and more fame. By this time, he had reserved a spot in the American music industry and stole the hearts of millions of fans. He even made it to the cover of Fader in the same year. This helped his image to gain even further recognition and popularity among the people. There were many successful incidents that took coherently taking place in Thug's life. However, some downfalls were also witnessed in the same year. The first difficult incident that happened with the stardom of Thug was when he decided to pay homage to his inspiration, Lil Wayne, by naming his album Carter 6 after the album of Lil Wayne that was named Carter. Lil Wayne was in return not very pleased by this and thus decided to threaten Thug with a lawsuit. It did not get too far, and eventually Thug was successful in settling this matter. This controversy ended quickly, and afterward, Thug was quick in changing the name of his album from Carter 6 to Barter 6. It was hence a difficult period, but it goes with the highs and lows that artists face during their participation in the music industry. However, when the album Barter 6 was released, it turned out to be a massive success for the rapper. Barter 6 was also able to secure the position of 22 on the Billboard 200. All the hassle then turned out perfectly fine for Young Thug. The music career of Thug did not always follow a smooth line. There were many times when he struggled with things. One time this happened when there was a data glitch that leaked some of his songs from his unreleased albums that would have been released under the names Slime Season and Slime Season 2. This was out of pure surprise, and it could lead to the loss of many million dollars, but Thug was quick to respond to this problem. What happened in return was that Thug immediately released both of the albums, and it saved him the loss of millions of dollars. If he hadn't taken the right step at the right time, then it could have caused major setbacks in the career of Young Thug. The music charts did not reward Thug highly for these albums, but he heard a lot of positive reviews that came directly from the music critics. One of the greatest stars of the industry, Kanye West was highly impressed by the unique rapping style of Young Thug. He was rather inspired by his passion and drive for rap music. Thus, he was quick to approach Thug, and they both agreed on collaborating for more projects. Kanye West also complimented Thug by stating that his rapping style was similar to that of Bob Marley. Thus, the year 2016 turned out extremely successful for the star because he collaborated with Kanye West on the song The Life of Pablo, and it was a tremendously rewarding song. Furthermore, later in the year 2016, Thug released another mixtape that goes by the name I'm Up. It was so successful that it was able to hit the music charts in America. On the Billboard 200, it was listed as number 22, and on the US Top R&B Hip Hop Albums Billboard, it was enlisted on number 6. This successful endeavor helped him to release the final part of the Slime series. He names this album Slime Season 3, and unlike the earlier two Slime counterparts, this one was able to earn him massive success and worth. In the August of the same year, Thug released another mixtape that was named Jeffrey. It became so popular that it earned the position of number 8 on the Billboard 200. Later on, this same mixtape was named among the top albums of the year 2016. His success was becoming incredibly inevitable that he arranged a mid-year tour for his mixtapes. He collaborated with Day-Day, TM88, and Rich the Kid on this tour. This tour was another turning point in the life of Thug. This happened because of the fact that he became a true style icon for many due to his mind-blowing fashion sense. He became tremendously popular among his followers, and along with that, he was also featured in the 2016's fall collection of Calvin Klein. During the time period that he was working on his music, he also did not cease to participate in collaborating with other music artists to display his incredible skills in rapping and music production. Amidst this, he first collaborated with Calvin Harris in his song Heatstroke. This song was a story of success. Later, he collaborated with Diplo on the song Bankroll. However, the most successful collaboration of Thug was with Camila Cabello in the song Havana. This song topped the Billboard chart in the year 2017 and became his first ever song to top off a Billboard chart and receive much appreciation for his talent and passion for rapping. His next extremely successful endeavor was his collaboration with Future to release the mixtape called Super Slimy. It was a huge turning point for Thug as this album made its way to the second position on the Billboard 200. After 2017, 2018 was a low-key year for Thug as this year he only provided the background vocals for a few artists. However, right after that, in the year 2019, he released a studio album which was called So Much Fun. This album was the ultimate reward as it paid off all the hard work of Thug. This happened because this album topped the charts of Billboard 200, and it had become his very first album to receive this title. The personal life of Young Thug was also not hidden from the public eye. By the age of 25, he was blessed with the news of 6 children that belonged to 4 different women. The last woman that he was engaged to went by the name Jerica Carlay, and she worked as a manager of a swimsuit line. Likewise, he was popularly known for his multiple talented brain. He never wrote the lyrics of any of his songs. He is a rather free-spirited person who formed the lyrics of his songs by using imagery in the form of drawing shapes and designs. He also won a Grammy for the 2019 Song of the Year, The Turbulent Present Life of Young Thug. However, the turbulent story of Young Thug and YSL did not end there. The greatest twist and downfall was witnessed by Thug when he was sent to trial for being accused of YSL being a supporter of a criminal street gang. What was furthermore shocking was the fact that his own lyrics were being used against him being accused of it. Currently, Young Thug is at the age of 31 years and is facing the trial of the biggest rap court cases that the country has ever witnessed. It has stopped Thug from making more rap songs at the prime time of his career, and this could lead to drastic consequences for his career. It could even cause the permanent halt of the rapper's career. Ever since then, Brian Steele, the lawyer of Young Thug, has stated the following words. I will tell you the response to any allegation is, Mr. Williams committed no crime whatsoever, and we will fight till the last drop of blood to clear him. All of these incidents took place on the 9th and 10th of May, 2022. What happened was that Young Thug, along with his 27 mates that are in direct association with YSL, was charged. YSL is short for Young Stoner Life, and it is the record label that has its music distribution done by 300 Entertainment. Now you must be wondering on what accounts the court accused them of this crime. For this, you need to know that they have been accused of 56 counts of criminal activity. The multiple alleged have been distributed on an 88-page indictment. Whereas, the different charges that are alleged include robbery, witness intimidation, murder, carjacking, attempted murder, possession of drugs and firearms. There have been some prosecutors in this, and they have alleged Young Thug as the leader of the gang and have further accused that he had very active participation in the street gang activities and had also been accused of violating the RICO Act. Now the story does not end here. There's more than accuses Young Thug here. That includes the lyrics and posts of Young Thug. The prosecutors have further alleged that the social media posts as well as the lyrics made by Young Thug have only intent in them and it is crime and violence. The story of Young Thug went further downhill when the authorities went the search of the home of Young Thug. There and then, he was charged with a further 7 felonies against him. However, the most significant one was the illegal possession of substances and firearms. His lawyer, Brian Steele, is fighting hard to save the life of his client. Since the time of Thug's arrest, he has been held captive in extremely unwell conditions. He has been contained in solid confinement, which is basically a windowless cement compartment. It is a very small area that consists only of one bed and a toilet. In the next hearing that happened in June, Young Thug was accused with a further claim that he had threatened all the members of YSL by stating to them that anyone who goes to courtroom and tells the God honest truth, they'll be fucking killed. The next major court hearing for Young Thug has been scheduled for 9th January 2023. All these incidents have predicted the ultimate end and downfall of the career of the once worldwide famous Young Thug. However, 300 Entertainment did not leave Young Thug alone at this time, and its founders Kevin Lyles, with the cooperation and support of Julie Greenwald, who is the chief operating officer of Atlantic Records, have launched a petition. This petition is named Protect Black Art. The ultimate goal of this petition is to halt and hinder the use of lyrics in order to use them as evidence in the court of the USA. The petition openly states that this practice isn't just a violation of First Amendment protections for speech and creative expression. It punishes already marginalized communities and silences their stories of family, struggle, survival, and triumph. On the 12th of June 2022, Young Thug addressed people by making a plea from jail. In his true words, he stated that, you know, this isn't just about me or YSL. I always use my music as a form of artistic expression, and I see now that black artists and rappers don't have that freedom. Everybody please sign the Protect Black Art petition and keep praying for us. I love you all, he concluded. The most important question that is laid over here by the people is whether this Grammy Award-winning rapper was singing about the crimes that he had actually committed or whether this rapper had been simply just openly expressing himself as a writer. Despite selling a total of 2.5 million albums and being hailed as being one of the most influential rappers in the history of America, today this man is behind the bars, and his career seems to be almost finished as there is no positive news about his escape currently. The good news here is that currently the U.S. claims to pass a new bill, and its ultimate goal is to stop the practice of raising questions regarding the artistic expression of different artists. Hip-hop is art, it is literature, it is poetry, it is free speech, it is journalism, and it should be protected as such, said Jamal Bowman, a congressman whose district includes the Bronx, New York, the birthplace of hip-hop. It should not be criminalized. The authorities have stated that they plan to seek the maximum possible penalties for the people charged in the indictment. For at least some of them, that could mean life in prison. This brings us to the think that this could be the end of success for Young Thug.